And there's the green flag. We are off to race again.
May motor racing in Indiana just got a lot quieter. Purdue University's second annual EV Grand Prix featured teams of student engineers pushing the boundaries of what is possible with electric power.
As you saw 39 go out with his on fire. I started to smell mine halfway through the race, so those yellow flags are actually pretty helpful.
Aggressive driving taxed the cars, the batteries, the drivers, but provided prime competition.
Yeah, I definitely felt them bump me through the last corner, and I knew I didn't have a whole lot of power left, so it was just a matter of staying, trying to weave in front of them. So.
Purdue has created an international consortium of universities working to train a new generation of engineers with the skills to revamp the auto industry by making electric vehicles feasible for everyone's everyday use. Purdue's outreach and proving ground drew an international field, including teams from Ireland and England, for whom the race was an arduous experience.
To start with, we had the electrics grounded out on the chassis. It took us like 15 minutes to get that fixed. We got on the grid, it was already just ready to go, and then the chain broke. So we came in, fixed it once, tried to go back out, it snapped again.
Most of the teams will travel to the Indianapolis Motor Speedway May 7th to compete against college teams from around the U.S.
It's a different mindset during the race. Like I said, to be patient and be calm and be smooth. You know, the gas-powered carts, we know how much fuel we have. We know how long we can go. Not so much in these carts.
The racers are keenly aware that they are pioneers for a new breed of transportation, just like the petrol-powered racers who descended on an Indianapolis pasture a century ago. Today's electric racers are already dreaming of what they and their successors will accomplish. At Purdue University, I'm Jim Shank.